Now we have a 5 working day rule. It's kind of weird one because it's the regulation designed to protect the importer or the licensed customs broker who acts on behalf of the importer more than customs and border protection as an agency. You usually see the regulations that are designed to protect the government agency, in this case customs. They're the ones who impose the rules and they're the ones who enforce them. But this one is an oddball, and this 5 working day rule says that if customs finds out that there is something wrong with the certificate of origin, right, they may issue a notice, right? And how long does the importer how much time does the importer have to respond, right? So this is designed to protect the importer in a way where if you don't respond within like 3 days, let's say, then we will seize the merchandise, we will issue a penalty, we will send this file to the fines, penalties, and forfeitures office. So in other words, the regulation is designed to protect the importer in this case. So customs examiners have tested on this. So instead of calendar day, we have working days, so that excludes weekends and that excludes holidays. It pretty much goes straight to the point. How many days? If the port director finds an NAFTA certificate of origin to be illegible, defective, or incomplete, the importer must be given at least blank amount of days to present correct certificate. Here, you just have to know this. 5 working day rule under section 181.22.